ECAT Concert Productions are sponsored by Doug King Builders Incorporated. ECAT would like to thank all sponsors for making coverage of all this year's concerts possible.
My name is Douglas King. I've been a developer and builder since 1966. Been building for over 55 years. Love what we do. Everything we built is something that I myself and my family would welcome to live in, and we've been successful, and the people that have bought from us are glad that they've done business with us. It's been a good journey, and we have hopefully a lot more to finish before we hang it up.
Beautiful gardens surrounding the Ames Free Library, and it's a pleasure to be back here again. I see many friendly faces. Some of you were much smarter than us. You brought cold drinks and something to eat. I hope you're in a sharing mood during intermission, though. My name is Steve Bell. I'm the director of this ensemble. And as I say, we've been here now for a number of years, and we're glad to do this. We owe our thanks to the library here for actually supporting our organization. Our entire music libraries for our performing groups is here. And without that storage, it would be a problem to have access and be able to access everything we need to for making up our concert schedules. So we're going to get started. We are missing a few people. So if you see, this time is very difficult for some people on the road, as you might imagine, weekday. So if you see people walking in, there's no punishment due them. We'll throw them over the cannon and hit it with a paddle later. But for right now, we're going to get started with our program. And I'll have to announce the numbers for you. The first number is entitled Sedona. Sedona plays homage to the Sedona, Arizona, which is a desert town near Flagstaff. It's surrounded by deep and steep canyon walls, pine forests, and red sandstone formations known as the Red Rock Buttes. These formations appear to glow in brilliant orange and red when illuminated by the rising or setting sun throughout Red Rock State Park. The listener can easily imagine how the following selection, Sedona, could have been a project or a soundtrack for a film written by Stephen Reinecke, and just use your imagination. I should want to say one thing about Stephen Reinecke. We do a lot of his numbers. He cut his teeth working with Eric Kunzel in the Cincinnati Pops Orchestra, sort of his mentor as he was going through the stages of getting to that point. And now he is a great composer and conductor for several organizations. In fact, he's actually conducted the Boston Pops on one occasion. This composition, again, is by Stephen Reinecke, Sedona. Hang in there, everyone. Thank you. Percussion gets three. One, two, three, and we begin, right? Thank you. good opening. Thank you. Our summer program is made up of many things. We've given 3 indoor concerts this past year, each with a theme. One of them was an Oktoberfest. Another one was sort of a greatest hits of the last 15 years. And most recently, we celebrated the introduction of a spring-summer season with the Caribbean Nights Pops concert. And so some of the selections are going to be coming from those programs. In fact, the next few are coming from that Caribbean Nights theme. Partey, thank you. Partey by Amy Webb. She was a native of Washburn, Maine, and received her music degree in music education from the University of Maine in 1996. We have some University of Maine people here. Where are they? 1, 2, there we go. We ought to give the University of Maine a little round of applause. Yes. So our next, this piece, Partey, it's just like it sounds. It's party time, incorporating familiar Latin rhythms and syncopations. It's a great way to be opening our concert this evening and get everyone in the party spirit. So let loose those inhibitions, relax, enjoy the upbeat nature of the Caribbean festive music. Just stay out of the pond down here, please, okay? All right. Okay, fun time. Percussion, we're all set to be awesome? Good. Written around 1863, after the Spanish composer Sebastian Radier had visited Cuba in 1861, this beautifully stylish Latin classic is still immensely popular with listeners and has been reinterpreted in diverse cultures, settings, arrangements, and recordings over the last 140 years. This wonderful lyric melody is effectively showcased in this arrangement by Jerry Nowak with some lush accompaniments and colorful, varied percussion. The name La Paloma translates as the dove, and it quickly became very popular outside of Spain, particularly in Mexico, and soon spread around the world. Over the years, the popularity of La Paloma has surged and receded periodically, but never has it gone away. It may be considered one of the first universally popular hits and has appealed to artists of diverse musical backgrounds. Interestingly, a little note, the composer Sebastian Radier was to die in obscurity within a few years, never to learn how popular this song would become. last selection, I mentioned a Cuba connection. And of course, that's right in the center of what goes on musically in the Caribbean. And so it is with this next piece entitled Blue Mambo. Blue Mambo was commissioned by the advanced band of the Woodwind Academy School and was premiered in April of 2017. Founded in 1900, Woodwind Academy is the oldest independent school in Atlanta, Georgia, and the largest in the continental United States. In its early years, it enjoyed a cordial relationship with the country of Cuba, resulting in a number of Cuban students boarding at the academy. Honoring this historical connection and looking ahead to the future, Blue Mambo uses as its basis the musical form and dance style, Mambo, which developed originally in Cuba, opening with a slow lyric introduction that features rich harmonies in a very bluesy style background. And this is for our lead trumpet player, Mr. Vin Macrina. And then we kick into an up-tempo mambo that kicks in with a great percussion groove as the piece concludes with this incredible dance rhythms that flavor all of the Cuban mambo. Organized and composed by Michael Sweeney, who's the current director of band publications at Highlighted Music in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. And it's a pleasure for us to do this for you this evening. This is Blue Mambo. Hey, Mr. Macrina. All right, clarinets that are here, play out because we need you.
Thank you. How's it going, D?
Okay.
Everyone's got their solos, right? Cool.
One of our concerts back in March was what we call our greatest hits. It was actually scheduled for 2020. We all remember about 2020. Let's not go on about it. But it was supposed to be a review of things we had done over the last dozen years or so. And that brought us to the next piece. We did it in 2010, starting on the Walpole Green that summer. And we had invited the composer, a gentleman by the name of Henry Goss, who has since passed away, to be our honored guest and conduct this piece, Casa Grande, which he wrote earlier in his life. Henry Goss enlisted in the Air Force right after graduating from his musical studies at Ithaca College. He also served as the Air Force's chief arranger and helped produce their weekly program, Serenade in Blue, and Time for Defense for the U.S. Air Force Radio. The idea of the song was to give some idea of what it was like to be in the great Southwest. Goss was quoted as saying, "Here one finds a land filled with both beauty and ugliness, evoking an impression of ageless serenity coupled with the vitality of great strength." He was a trombone soloist, and there are opportunities in this particular piece for trombone solo and clarinet solo. Enjoy Casa Grande.
Tiffany's all set, right, for this one?
Good.
Thank you.
Well, given the temperature tonight, I like to think back to October. It was certainly cooler. And I mentioned we did an Oktoberfest, one of our first that we've done over the years. It was really kind of fun because it brought out a lot of music that we're not used to hearing on a regular basis. Europeans certainly are. But it'll be fun tonight as we get into this part of our program. We have a few of these pieces coming your way right now. The first one is a march called Alpine Legion. It was composed in 1983 for the University of North Texas Wind Ensemble, which, by the way, is one of the premier college or collegiate wind ensembles in the United States. It received its public premiere in February of 1996 under the baton of the March King, Frederick Fennell, who was directing the Dallas Wind Symphony at the time. Composed as a light-spirited march, it features a trumpet duet of the trio and some yodeling-style counter-melodies. These are terrific. There are tantalizing woodwind riffs as well as stirring low brass and reed features as the piece draws to its climactic ending. And I think you get the spirit of what's going on. This is called Alpine Legion. I'm sorry? I'm going to do that one first. Alpine Legion. Because all of a sudden, it's disappeared. Don't know where it happened. Don't know it's gone. We'll probably skip over.
We're doing
Alpine Legion.
Okay.
Don't know where it went, though.
All right.
It could be in my folder, too, for all I know. We all set tech time. Thank you. Pennsylvania poker, right? Well, this tune will certainly be familiar to all of you. The Pennsylvania poker has been known under various names as it appears to have had an uncertain history as to its birth. Originally named the Laughing Poker by one source, the tune began in the early 1920s in the Scranton, PA area, and some of the lyrics specifically mention that city. Popularized by the Andrews Sisters in the 1940s, and of course heralded in the movie Groundhog Day in 1993, the Pennsylvania Polka was adopted as the state song by the Pennsylvania General Assembly in November of 1990. Now the woodwind poker.
Okay.
I need to swap some music. I will take a drink.
Thank you.
Is she really?
Yeah.
Okay, you got to keep waiting down this whole thanks.
Yeah, Joe's got to do the part of 43.
All right.
That's good. Well, as Lawrence Welk might have said, it's poker time, everybody. And we've just had one poker. We're going to back it up with one more. This is perhaps even more famous than the last one. The woodwind poker is best known as the clarinet poker. and it evolved from a simple melody shared by Estonian, Polish, and German musicians. The familiar tune as we know it today was formalized in the early 20th century and adopted the name clarinet polka. Thankfully, we only have 5 clarinets out of our 10 here tonight. The arranger, Andy Clark, wrote this arrangement so that all of the woodwinds could participate in this fun lyric melody. So, in his own words, why should the clarinets just have all the fun? So, here it is, the woodwind polka. That's it. Mallet players. We do not play 151 to 155. Remember that, Amy? Mark it. Okay, good. Something a little more contemporary. Paul Frederick Simon is one of the most celebrated American singers and songwriters of the 20th century. Simon has had a career that now spans 6 decades. Born in New Jersey, Simon grew up in Queens, New York City, where he developed an interest in rock music in his teens and began performing in 1956 with his high school friend, Art Garfunkel. Simon and Garfunkel came into prominence in the 1960s because of their unique blend of folk and rock music. With a string of hits such as The Sound of Silence, Mrs. Robinson, Bridge Over Troubled Water, The Boxer, these songs all served as a soundtrack to the counterculture of that age. Composer and arranger Tom Wallace has selected several of their well-known tunes and has presented them in this band arrangement entitled The Genius of Paul Simon. And if you can name all the tunes, then you must have been a fan. Broadway begins.
Yeah. Thank you. Japanese in the game. Let's cut to Radetzky Mark right now. We're going to wrap up after this set, okay? Cut to Radetzky. I'm taking a break.
Along with the Blue Danube Waltz by composer Johann Strauss Jr., his Radetzky March has become an unofficial Austrian national anthem. Dedicated to Field Marshal Joseph Radetzky von Raditz, I wonder if he was related to Dick, was first performed on 31st August in 1848 in Vienna, and soon became popular among regimented marching soldiers. Strauss was commissioned to write the piece to commemorate Radetzky's victory at the Battle of Custoza, which is also known as the First War of Independence for the Italians. Today, the theme is used in numerous promotional jingles and at major sporting events, in particular at soccer matches for the Austrian national team. When it was first played in front of Austrian officers, they spontaneously clapped and stamped their feet when they heard the chorus. In keeping with this tradition, I will call upon you, the audience, to join in with your enthusiastic clapping at the appropriate time, I'll let you know, as we bring the first half of our program this evening to a close, the Radetzky March.
Everyone remembers all the cuts, I mean, the cuts, the jump. Make sure you hit the jumping around, ready to go.
Give us about 10 minutes and we'll be right back with the second part of the program. Thank you. Wow. Okay, let's get going with the second portion of our program here. Everyone was enjoying your congeniality. Thank you very much for that. But we're going to start our second part of our program with a very familiar march called Semper Fidelis. There is not an original general order to document the proclamation of Semper Fidelis as the official march of the Marines, but a visit to the United States Marine Corps website refers to the song as the official march of the Marine Corps. In 1880, John Philip Sousa began as the musical conductor of the United States Marine Corps Band, known as the President's Own. He led the band through five presidential administrations. During that time, Chester A. Arthur, 21st President of the United States, felt that Hail to the Chief was undignified and requested a new presidential song. So Sousa began working on the new composition. But President Arthur predeceased its completion and never heard what he had requested. Faithful to the task he had been accepted, his new composition was to become known as Semper Fidelis, Always Faithful. That's something that I didn't realize till today when I did some research. There you go.
It is. See? We all think it's something else. And... okay. Percussion solo in the middle, don't forget. Okay, here we go.
I mentioned the name of John Williams, and I don't really need to say too much. You all know who he is, what he's accomplished, what he's done for the soundtracks, for movies, his compositions. He's directed the Boston Pops. I think he's just about done it all. He's just a fantastic musician, and his musical scores come to life. It's been just wonderful to be able to witness this firsthand and to have that connection here in Boston. This next piece, arranged by Robert W. Smith, features some tunes that John Williams has written. He entitles this composition Soaring with John Williams, follows a theme. First, you're going to hear the Superman March, of course, which we're all very familiar with. But then, in a movie called Empire of the Sun, there was this very moving passage when the fighters coming finally into play for the United States. It's called Cadillac of the Skies, and it's a gorgeous, beautiful tune that he uses. And then we end with Star Wars, the main title. So we hope you enjoy Soaring with John Williams. Hey, trumpets, horns, here we go. Oh, they're nice, please.
Thank you.
We're going to return just briefly to our Oktoberfest again. We probably ought to put together a social gathering after this concert tonight to this effect. The Beer Barrel Polka comes from a Czech love song by Jaromír Vévoda named Skoda Lásky. Depending on the version you hear, this rollicking polka tune is either about recalling a lost love or getting your pals together for an evening of pub entertainment. See what I mean? It is also known as Rosamund, and the lyrics were added in 1936 and quickly became a hit for the Andrews Sisters. It is said that the Beer Barrel Polka was brought to England by Czech airmen during World War II. The translated lyrics became General Dwight D. Eisenhower's favorite melody, and Eisenhower had the author of that translated lyrics, Vaclav Zeman, spirited off to England to thank him personally for the morale-building effect of that song, the Beer Barrel Polka.
Even generals knew what they were doing.
Thank you.
All right, let's skip a few.
Bless you.
Saints?
Let's go over to Carnaval in Sao Paulo, please. Carnaval in Sao Paulo. What do you have to sign here, please?
7:34.
That's what I thought. We're over schedule now. We'll just do a couple in America. We'll call it. Now, the longer we do this, the more it feels like a Caribbean night, doesn't it? Woo! Carnaval in Sao Paulo. In a tribute to Brazil's annual Carnival Festival, composer James Barnes chose to use the celebration that is held in Sao Paulo, the largest Portuguese-speaking city in the world, as his focus point for this upbeat, up-tempo, and lively selection. The city and the surrounds of Sao Paulo exert strong international influences in commerce, finance, arts, and entertainment. The city's name also honors the apostle, St. Paul of Tarsus. This is a wonderful Afro-Brazilian samba, which is the main attraction at most carnivals. And the samba in Sao Paulo has a distinct, heavier percussion rhythm known as Gest a Samba de Trabalho, or the Samba of Work. The city's carnival may not have the same reputation as Rio, but the city knows how to throw a party. We hope you enjoy Carnival in Sao Paulo.
Time. Well, the time has flown by, Have you had a lot of fun tonight? Good, I'm glad. I'm not sure we have yet. We got to figure out how this is all going to cool down. No, we're so glad you came out. We know many of you are friends and follow us. There are a lot of tunes we did not get to tonight. If you follow us on Facebook at all, SharonBands.org, there will be other events this summer that we're playing at you could attend. And I hope we'll see some of those friendly faces at those events as well. But we want to again thank the Ames Library for having us here. It's been a wonderful time. What lovely place to have a concert, no question about it. Thank you. And as our summer concerts have gone over many years now, we always like to close our performance with a wonderful rendition of America the Beautiful by Carmen Dragan.
Thank you.
Thank you all very much. Go home safely, and we hope to see you at another concert this summer. God bless. Take care.
ECAT Concert Productions are sponsored by Doug King Builders Incorporated. ECAT would like to thank all sponsors for making coverage of all this year's concerts possible.
My name is Douglas King. I've been a developer and builder since 1966. Been building for over 55 years. Love what we do. Everything we built is something that I myself and my family would welcome to live in, and we've been successful, and the people that have bought from us are glad that they've done business with us. It's been a good journey, and we have hopefully a lot more to finish before we hang it up.